Welcome to another T-Studio demo. Today I'm going to show you how to draw the perfect cube in two-point perspective. I'm using for my materials today paper, a red and graphite pencil, eraser, a ruler and T-square, as well as a set of drafting triangles. Drawing rectilinear solids like boxes are quite easy. However, what happens when your piece requires the perfect cube in which all sides are equal? Well, that's what this video is going to be all about. To start, we're going to set up our drawing space first by locating a horizon line, a center of vision, a line of sight, station point, and now left and right vanishing points. Remember that our vanishing points correspond to each other, so we can use our 90-degree corner of the triangle and station point to help us locate them. Once I'm satisfied with where I want to put them, I make sure to mark them on the horizon line, and I will label them, of course, LVP for left vanishing point and RVP for right vanishing point. I'm also going to need a point on the horizon line that is at a 45-degree angle or centered between those two vanishing points. This will help us get the base of our cube drawn so that each of its sides are equal. Now remember that they're not going to look the same length due to the principles of diminution and foreshortening, which is part of linear perspective. I will now start my square plane with just a point and lines drawn to the two vanishing points, one to the right and one to the left. I will also draw a line to that third point in the center, which I'm going to call the center vanishing point. Now, I choose a length on one of the sides by locating a point on this line here on the left, and then from that point, I'm going to draw across towards the right vanishing point, and where that new line intersects that line that goes from that front corner back to that center vanishing point, it gives me a new point, and that then I can draw a line to the left vanishing point all the way forward to that right front line, and I have the perfect square in perspective. Now, the challenge is to give height to this cube, so here are the steps that you need to follow. First, draw a horizontal measuring line that passes through the closest point of our drawn square, and I'm going to label it ML. Next, I'm going to take the measurement from either the left or right vanishing point and the station point and rotate that length to the horizon line. Now, I'm going to pass a line from that new point through the farthest corner point of that square that I've already drawn all the way down to that measuring line. The distance from this new point in the front corner of the square is actually the height, so I just need to rotate that distance vertically and I'll have that top front corner of my cube. Now make sure that you make good measurements. It's always a good idea to double check before you make any marks, just so that you're more accurate. Now, with that point, I can easily finish off the cube. Now that I have the box correctly drawn, I just switch to my graphite pencil and trace over the important construction lines. I hope you found this video useful. Thanks for watching, and happy drawing!